Now, let us look at one example, okay? Let us assume in a query you have an expression that says salary, and then you multiply it by 100, and then you divide it by 5, and let us add 20, and then divide it by 10, and then we'll minus 5. Okay, this is the expression that we have in our SQL query. Now, what we will do is, we'll first solve this query without using the precedence rule. Okay, we'll not follow this rule and we'll try to solve the query as it comes in front of us. Okay, so first we'll be solving these two, and then whatever the result is, then we'll be solving these two, and then whatever the result is, then we'll use the operator and make sure we are not following the precedence rule. We'll just go in a flow, right? So what happens? Let's take there is an employee whose salary is 1000. So let me pull up calculator. Now what happens when you go in a flow and when you follow the precedence rule? We'll see both the answers. Okay, so salary is 1000, and then so first we are solving these two operators, correct? So these two, so 1000 is the salary and I will multiply it by 100, so we got how much? $100,000. Yeah, that's the salary. And then next we move forward, we divide it by 5, so let us divide it by 5, so that is 20,000, and then 20,000 plus 20, so we'll have to add 20, so 20,020, and then this is the result for all this, and then we'll divide it by 10, so divided by 10, so 2002, and then we subtract 5, perfect, so we'll subtract 5, so 1997, let me see, is that the correct, 2002 minus 5, yeah, 1997, perfect. So the answer without using precedence rule, what's the answer? 1997. So now using precedence rule, let us look at what answer we'll get, okay? So salary is same, 1000. Let us look at the precedence rule. What precedence rule says that we'll have to first solve the brackets. So we don't have any brackets in this equation, perfect. So we can ignore it. Next, we'll have to solve the division and multiplication. Okay, so let us try and solve it. So salary is 1000. I'm just substituting the salary variable, and let us write the complete equation again, divided by 5 by 20, divided by 10, and minus 5. Perfect. So that's how our equation will look like. Now, when we have to solve the division and multiplication, let us see how our equation simplifies. 1000 multiplied by 100, so 1000 and double zero, right? And then we have division by 5. So for now, what I'm doing is I'm just writing it divided by 5. We'll solve it in the next stage. Plus, then we have 20 divided by 10. So it will be 2, and then minus 5. Perfect. So that's the first stage. So what we did is, based on the precedence rule, we only solved the multiplication in this equation, and also over here we solve the division, right? Now again, in this equation, if we look at the precedence rule, we see that there is another division that is there. So what we do, we divide it by 5, so 1 2 3 4 5 divided by 5. What did I do? 1 2 3 4 5 divided by 5. So 20,000, our equation becomes 20,000 plus 2 minus 5. Now based on the precedence rule, the next operators that we need to solve is plus and minus. So what's the answer? 20,000 plus 2 minus 5. Now can you see this is the answer when we follow the precedence rule? So what's the answer? 19,997. Now without using the precedence rule, it is 1,997. This is the problem. If you do not know the precedence rule, in your certification exam, you might give up or you might come up with wrong answers to the equations. So you got to remember these all operators and the precedence rule in the order in which they are solved.